And welcome back, as today I am going to be presenting you with another match preview of the 2023-24 season as we both look ahead to a Saturday's game as Walsall are back on the road again in League 2 as we make the trip to Wiltshire to take on former Saddlers boss Michael Flynn and his Swindon Town team. But before we do go any further, as you can already tell, I am delighted to be joined by Malcolm, who is of course a Swindon Town fan. He has kindly agreed to come on and give his thoughts ahead of Saturday's game from a Swindon point of view. And has actually got a bit of a secret to tell all fans watching this preview, which I'm sure he will mention during the course of this video. So firstly, Malcolm, would you just like to introduce yourself to the viewers watching at home to give them just an insight into what you do towards Swindon Town?
I'm actually mascot, so Rocket Mobbing, so you'll see me on the pitch before games. A little bit mad sometimes, but yeah, it's good fun to have a bit of banter with it.
Yeah, that's good stuff, mate. But let's finally get into the main subject of conversation of today's video, which is of course the preview itself. But first question, what's the mood like around the club at the moment going into Saturday's game? As of course you come into this one full of confidence after beating Sutton United 5-3 last weekend, and are also the only team in League 2 which are still unbeaten without a single loss.
Yeah, I think the buzz around the club is absolutely buzzing. I mean, it's obviously we've new manager as such this season. He's been in since the last game of last season, but yeah, it's just it feels a bit like going back a couple of years. We've had a couple of really bad years. With the football's not been brilliant, and I think it's the way we're playing, attacking football, scoring plenty of goals, conceding plenty of goals. But it's the atmosphere around the club is just really good, positive vibes going. So yes, it's looking forward to Saturday. Looking forward to every game at the moment, which is not what we could be saying for the last couple of years.
Yeah, that's good stuff, mate. Obviously, moving on to the next question in there, but where would you say Swindon's main strength is on the field? And what players do you think could cause a real threat for Walsall's backline on Saturday?
So, we've got the most lethal striker in Europe at the moment. So, Jake Young, obviously on loan from Bradford. So, like all good strikers from Bradford, he's banging the goals in. So, Dan Kemp is been superb. Just the whole attacking, Charlie Austin, just he's not scoring so many goals, but he's the contribution he's put into the team is just amazing. Drawing defenders off, obviously let the others score. It's just our tempo from front to back is just really, really good. So yeah, I think you've got a lot to look out for, but I think you're in form as well. So I think it'll be it won't be as high scoring or a free throw in
the years. Yeah, that's good stuff, mate. Obviously, we'll go on to mention a few of the former Walsall players later on in the video. Just to touch on there, Tory Shade obviously joined Swindon, I think it was two seasons ago when he left Walsall. So how has he been like as a player, as a whole for Swindon since joining?
See, but again, I think he's kind of, some people kind of like him, some people don't. He's not really set the world alight, but he's a steady, steady player. There was rumours he was going, in the summer, but so yeah, I think he's steady. I think he's kind of more seen as possibly as backup maybe for the team now, but he does a job when he comes on.
Obviously, very similar to his time at Walsall. Some fans, like you said there, some fans did like him, some fans disliked him. Obviously, he's very quick on the ball. He's fast. Does like to chip in with a goal there and then. But again, he's a typical right back in League 2, isn't he? Which just leads me on to the next question of today's match preview, which looking at stats from last season until now, you have happened to have scored a total amount of 20 goals in 8 games in all competitions. Which again is the highest in the division. So would you say your team's biggest asset is going forward and attacking?
Yeah, definitely. So we look really, really good going forward. We are kind of leaking goals at the back, but that's not to say that we're playing that badly. I mean, Wrexham, for instance, 5-5, played really, really well, 4-1 at half time, kind of let it slip, but it was more like a playoff game than you know, normal League Two games. It was the atmosphere was just amazing. And we played a game less than everybody else, and obviously had a 0-0 draw in it as well. So just shows, you know, quite how many goals we're scoring and how attacking we are. But I think we need to kind of be kind of mindful that we can't be doing that all the time. So there might come a point when, you know, we have to settle for a 1-0 maybe. I think my nerves would take 1-0 better.
Yeah, obviously, because you had that opening day, the opening day cancelled, didn't you, against Colchester, which obviously not the stuff in of a few players. Obviously, you feel for the fans, really, don't you? Because I think you had a few fans travelling up on the day. Obviously, you got postponed due to the weather. Who would have thought you had a game postponed in the summer, which is equally for you, isn't it? Frustrating. So obviously, you have to play that game in hand now. Whenever during the course of the season, but it obviously, like I said, that knocks the stuff out of a few of your players. But again, moving on to the next question now, which is a question which most Walsall fans would ask if they was in my seat right now. But of course, you did sign a Walsall legend, Liam Kinsella, in the summer, who has been one of, or if the best player to play for the Saddlers in the last 5 years or so. But how has he been performing so far this season for yourselves? And will he potentially make a start on Saturday against his former club?
So we're not really seeing much of him. I think it's more because of obviously the players that we're playing have been too well. So I was chuffed when he signed, because, you know, being such a good player for Walsall, and obviously watching Walsall, seeing how good he was for them, but for you guys. So we're not seeing sort of a lot of him. I think he played the game I can remember playing, it was Forest Green. I think. A lot of our fans say he was lucky to stay on the pitch with a bit of a reckless tackle. But, I think I'd like to see more of him. But, I can definitely see there's a player in there. So looking forward to seeing a bit more of him during the
season. Yeah, 100%. You definitely have got to play with Liam Kinsella. He's a one, you know, top quality player for League Two. And I think he's playing way beneath himself in League Two. I definitely do think he should be pushing higher for League One, if not Championship. But obviously for me, he's one of the best players I've seen play for Walsall in a long time. He was one of my favourite players since supporting Walsall. I've been supporting Walsall a good 11 to 12 years now, and he's been one of my favourite players since then. So I do think you've got a cracking player in Liam Kinsella there for the rest of this season and for the foreseeable future. But moving on to the penultimate question of today's match preview, which is of course talking about the gaffer, who all Saddlers fans know about quite a lot. Having been our head coach for the majority of last season, which is, of course, Michael Flynn. But I'm not going to ask how he is like as a manager, having all those Walsall fans knowing what he is like. But how has he been as a manager for yourselves since being appointed? And are you happy with Flynn as your current manager in charge?
We've had taken over from Jody Morris. He was an absolute breath of fresh air. He came on the pitch at half-time when he took over, when he was announced. And I think he had most Swindon fans, the first couple of sentences he said, we were like, this is this person. And he's come, you know, he wanted players that play with passion, that want to play for the club. If they don't want to play for the club, you know, go. All that sort of stuff that you want to hear from a manager. But he's actually, you know, he's followed it up. He's really, really kind of, he comes across that he's really proud to be sort of the manager, and everything he says is just, you know, comes across really well. So and he's backing up. He said we're going to play attacking football. He said he was here to entertain, and he's backing up everything he said. So so far so good, I'd say. You know, obviously unbeaten, so can't complain.
Of course, mate. Obviously, you know, for me personally, I did really like Michael Flynn towards the back end of last season, but I'm not obviously going to say that, because you could argue that some managers settled in at different clubs, which obviously it seems that way for yourselves. Obviously, having been unbeaten so far this season, obviously he's doing something right. As Dewey's doing something right at Swindon, so I'm sure he'll be a good manager for yourselves and for the rest of this season and for the forever how long he'll be appointed as head coach for Swindon. But okay then. We are pretty much at the end of today's match preview, but like always, we can't end the show off by not having a score prediction, can we? So, Malcolm, what is your score prediction for Saturday's game?
So, I think it'll be close. I say this every game that we've had so far, but I think it'll definitely be a bit closer than the other games. Walsall have had some really good results. I've looked at recently. They beat Salford away. Did you beat Gillingham? I don't. Or you had some good results. I know. See that. Sorry if I didn't get them right. But I'd say I'd be happy with 2-1. 2-1 Swindon.
It's a tough one, isn't it? Because I think both teams perform as well. Yeah, obviously, I personally think it's going to be a close game as well. Both teams, I think, will score. It's going to be a difficult one against yourselves, and I'm sure you'll probably say the same, Emma Bedras, as well. But for me, going into Saturday's game, I do think it is going to be a tough one. And personally, yourselves are in great form coming into this one. And me knowing Michael Flynn too well, he will probably want to put one over on his former team on Saturday. But I am hoping we're also going to replicate last weekend's away win to Salford, and fingers crossed, we make it back-to-back away wins. But if I had to go for a score prediction, I will probably go for a score draw like I did last weekend. As I have gone for a 2-2 draw, as I can see both teams scoring throughout the whole 90 minutes or forever along we play nowadays, because obviously the new EFL time edition they added on the start of the season, forever long we play to 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Obviously, we have 10 minutes added on nearly for every game now. I'm happy for a good game all round on Saturday. It's going to be a tough one, but I'm looking forward to it. I've got my ticket already as well, so hopefully I'll be looking for you on the pitch as well, Malcolm, on Saturday as well, which I'm sure we'll pass each other on the day. But that just, of course, brings us to the end of today's match preview. Malcolm, thank you so much for coming on the show and chatting about Saturday's game. I do very much appreciate it. Now we'll leave a link to your X handle in the description below, so Saddlers and Swindon fans, make sure to go and check that out. And I shall see you on Saturday for the match direction of Saturday's big game against Swindon Town away from home. And until then, up the Saddlers.